This is Tamika, a new me, 1109, and it's time to do the final weigh-in for our Spring Losers 5-week weight loss challenge. I think I might have screwed that name up, but that's what it is. Okay, so my entry weight was 230 pounds. My goal was to lose 16 pounds during the challenge. This morning I weighed 213 pounds. So I was able to exceed my goal by 1 pound, so I'm excited about that. And 16 was a stretch because I initially thought 15 pounds. And so I said, okay, let me give myself another pound, and I was able to do it. I was a little concerned at some point because, as I mentioned, I think in the last video, I had started having some health challenges and mine getting a little screwy, and I started reaching for those high calorie drinks that we're supposed to stay away from, and found myself being a little off track because I couldn't necessarily eat, so I was drinking a couple times. I did do that. Anyway, I made it, lost 17 pounds from February 17th through today, March 27th, and I am really excited. I love challenges because I feel like it helps me stay accountable. I like looking at everybody else's progress, hearing some challenges and wins and victories for them, because I feel like, you know, it's a way for us to learn from each other. So I'm looking forward to the next challenge, wondering who's going to host it. If you guys hear about any challenges that are coming up, make sure you share that information with me, because I really, really, really want to be able to participate. Again, challenges keep me on track. So, last week, Bandit Wendy asked me a couple questions in comment. I haven't forgotten. I just was trying to figure out, okay, when do I answer? So, the one question that you asked me was, I think it was something like, what is the easiest part of this journey? I think. I'm going to go with that. So, or how is the journey easy? I think it was more like that. So, I think my journey is easy when I stick to the plan. When I stick to those 10 steps to a successful weight loss surgery or lap band surgery that I was given the day that I was discharged from the hospital, I feel like my journey is at its best and its easiest. And I did make a video. The quality wasn't all that great, but I'll go ahead and attach the link in the info bar in case you guys haven't seen that. But when I stick to the plan, I work out well. When I deviate from the plan, and let me give you an example of how I've deviated here lately. I have turned into quite the couponing diva. And what was happening was I was going and I was doing all this couponing and I was grocery shopping and I wasn't buying those favorite things that I like that work for me, and I got myself off track. So when I started deviating and trying to figure out, okay, what's on sale and what do I have a manufacturing coupon for, you know, what am I going to pick up that way, and I wasn't picking up my Baby Bells and my Laughing Cows and, you know, my yogurts that I like and all of the things that worked well for me thus far, I got off track. I think another question that you had was, what is the hardest part of this journey? And I think I probably just answered that a little bit. And I think another thing for me right now in my life, in this moment, the hardest thing is dealing with something that I did not expect. And so, and the emotions of that. And I think that will probably just happen with all of us at, you know, at some point during this journey, just with life in general. So dealing, you know, with the fact that, yeah, you know, I have been an emotional eater for the majority of my life, and I'm in my emotions right now. How do I channel that, and how do I make sure that I don't get myself off track with what I am doing right now with my lap band? So that has been hard. And what I do, you know, on a very regular basis is remind myself how I got to the point of being, you know, on a gurney, being wheeled to an operating room to have lap band surgery. I think about how long it took me from when I got my goal weight until I got my surgery date, which was a year. I think about not wanting to have any band slippage and erosion and all of those things. I think about just how I want to be successful in general, and that gets me back on track I think another question you asked was, do I have any mental conversations? Absolutely, all the time. Because a lot of times it's just us in our own little worlds doing this thing. Yeah, we have this community online and we make videos and we talk to each other. But the day-to-day, we're by ourselves daily when we're trying to figure out, are we exercising? Are we eating right? Are we getting our protein, taking our vitamins? All of those things. We're living this life that, yeah, we report out on, but for the most part, it's really up to us and what we have decided to do with this gift. I mean, I call it a gift. I think it's a complete blessing that I was able to have weight loss surgery, and I'm thankful for it, and I try not to take it for granted, and I try not to take advantage of it. So when I'm having those mind conversations with myself, I am saying, what goals are you setting for yourself? Are you rewarding yourself, as you meet these milestones? Like, I was so wrapped up in developing some other goals for different parts of my life that I didn't create a goal for losing this 16 pounds. And so now I need to figure out, how am I going to reward myself? Because it's very important when you're setting goals in life that you're also putting rewards in place at the same time. So that, because you accomplish something and you owe something to yourself, big, small, whatever, the case, but you owe something to yourself. So I have to go back and figure out what my reward will be, and I'll make sure that I share it with you guys. I have lots and lots and lots of thoughts, though. That was a very good, those were three very good questions, Wendy. And I think I'll probably make another video just to go in more detail. But to wrap this up, entry weight 230 pounds, and today I'm 213 pounds. So, everybody did an excellent job. See you guys later. Take care. Bye.